Good morning, students. Welcome to the YouTube channel of our school. Today we are continuing with the same chapter, Electricity. In this chapter, today we are going to study about power and heating effect of electric current and its applications. So let's start our class. So students, electric power is the electrical work done per unit time. Power is equals to work done upon time taken. So SI unit of power is watt. Now, how can we define 1 watt? 1 watt of power means when 1 joule of work is done per second. Okay, if 1 joule of work is done in 1 second, then the power would be 1 watt. So we can say the power of 1 watt is the rate of working of 1 joule per second. We have different formulas for calculating the electric power. These are the formulas. Power is equals to potential difference into current. Power is equals to square of current multiplied by resistance. And power is equals to square of potential difference divided by resistance. So P is equals to VI, P is equals to I square R, and P is equals to V square upon R. Electrical energy is equals to power multiplied by time. E is equals to P into T. Factors on which electrical energy consumed by an electric appliance depends is the power rating of appliance and for how much time the appliance is used. If we know the power rating of appliance and if we know the time, then we will multiply both these factors and we will obtain electrical energy. Now unit of electrical energy is watt hour, because watt is the unit of power and unit of time is hour. So watt R is the unit of electrical energy. So 1 watt R is the amount of electrical energy consumed when an electrical appliance of 1 watt power is used for 1 hour. Suppose there is an electrical appliance whose power is 1 watt, and if we are running the electrical appliance for 1 hour, then the electrical energy consumed will be 1 watt R. The commercial unit of electrical energy. Commercial unit of electrical energy is kilowatt hour. Kilowatt hour जो हमारे meters की जो reading होती है वो हम किसमें कौन सी unit में find out करते हैं? Kilowatt hour. So this is the commercial unit of electrical energy. So 1 kilowatt hour is the amount of electrical energy consumed when an electrical appliance of power 1 kilowatt is used for 1 hour. Okay students, now we will study the relationship between the kilowatt hour and joule. So 1 kilowatt hour we know, 1 kilowatt for 1 hour. 1 kilowatt hour we can write, we know that 1 kilowatt is equals to 1000 watt. So we can write 1000 watt for 1 hour. But we know 1 watt is equals to 1 joule divided by 1 second. Power. Power is the rate of work done divided by time taken. So 1 watt of power is equals to 1 joule divided by 1 second. So now 1 kilowatt hour is equals to 1000 joules per second for 1 hour. And we know that 1 hour contains 3600 seconds. Or we can say 60 into 60 seconds. So 1 kilowatt hour becomes 1000 joules per second into, for 1 hour we will write 60 multiply 60 seconds. So seconds will get cancelled from second and we will obtain 1 kilowatt hour is equals to 36 lakh joules. Or we can also write it like this, 3.6 into 10 raised to the power 6 joules. So this is the relationship between 1 kilowatt hour and joules. So 1 kilowatt hour is equals to 3.6 into 10 to the power 6 joules. Now, heating effect of electric current. Whenever electric current is passed through a high resistance wire like nichrome wire, its resistance wire becomes very hot and the heat is produced. This effect is known as heating effect of electric current. We see in our day-to-day life many electrical appliances like electric iron, electric toaster, all right, electric rod. Whenever electric current is passed through these appliances, they become hot. So this effect is known as heating effect of electric current. Now, Joule's law of heating. Joule's law of heating means heat produced by the electric appliance, or we can say a conductor, is directly proportional to I square RT. Okay, H is directly proportional to power of current, H is directly proportional to resistance of the wire, and H is directly proportional to the time for which current is passed. Now, if we double the amount of current passing through the wire, then the heat produced will become 4 times, because here current is already in square. Okay, so if we suppose earlier the current was passing 2 ampere, now we have raised the current to 4 ampere, so heat produced will become 4 times, and if we half the current, then heat produced will be 1/4. Now for resistance, if we double the resistance, then heat produced will be double, and if we reduce or lower the resistance, the heat produced will also be lower. If we double the time, then heat produced will also be doubled. And if we reduce the time, then heat produced will also be reduced. So according to Joule's law of heating, the heat produced will be directly proportional to square of current, resistance, and time. Now we will deal with some applications of heating effect of electric current. Since heating effect of electric current is used in the working of electric iron, electric kettle, toaster, electric oven, room heaters, etc. It is also used in electric bulbs for producing light. We know that in electric bulb, whenever we switch on the light, light is produced, but at the same time heat is also produced. Heating effect of electric current is also used in electric fuse for protecting household wiring and electrical appliances. Okay students, now here are some questions. Like the first question is, why tungsten metal is used for making filaments of electric bulb? The filament of electric bulb is made up of tungsten. Why it is made up of tungsten? Because tungsten has a very high melting point. Alright. And tungsten filament can be kept white hot without melting away. It has a very high melting point and it does not burn at a high temperature. The next question is, why electric bulb is filled with a chemically unreactive gas like argon or nitrogen? So why these gases are filled in the bulb? These gases are unreactive gases, or we can say inert gases. So they will not react with the hot tungsten filament, and thus the life of the tungsten filament would be prolonged. So to not to react the tungsten filament at high temperature, we fill the electric bulb with the unreactive gases like argon and nitrogen. So student, this was all about the chapter electricity. I hope you all have understood the chapter well. Thank you for watching. See you in the next class.